president, Mr. Kamal Shiraz, and this will be my presentation. So please welcome.
The human brain, ladies and gentlemen, is a wonderful thing, says George Jessel. The human brain is a wonderful thing. It starts working the moment you are born, and it never stops until you stand up in front of public to speak. So why does it happen that we know that we are very confident in the information that we have, in the knowledge that we have, but when we come over here on the stage to give a speech, to talk about that knowledge, to talk about that information, we go totally blank. And the best tool that gives you this power to stand on your feet and to speak up is the table topic session, dear Toastmaster. Speaking extempore, speaking on your feet with unprepared speech, dear Toastmaster. And today's education session is exactly on that. Being a member for 5 years, I still remember when I was first invited in a table topic session, my name was called and my heart started beating and I started shivering. I never wanted to come over here. But when I came over here, the topic that was given to me, I never understood the question. I never understood the topic even. I got a nervous breakdown and then I went back on my seat. And that was the day I decided that I'm gonna derive a formula that is going to make me a best table topic speaker. So I made a formula, a very simple formula, dear Toastmasters. And I was nervous about that formula at first, but in a contest, table topic context that was held in 2014, I got third position. I used that formula and that made me sure that this formula really, really works. And today I'm going to share with you that formula. So are you ready for the formula, dear Toastmasters?
Yes.
Awaaz maza nahi aaya ji. Are you ready for the Toastmaster, for the formula, dear Toastmasters? Yes, that's the spirit. The formula is very simple, Marker. The formula has got only three words, and it is very easy to remember as well. The formula is SAP, SAP. This is the formula, very simple formula. And trust me, it works because it has worked for me and it has worked for the 25 badges of our workshop, the Nitty Gritty of Public Speaking that we have conducted over the last 4 years, because I've been sharing this formula for over last 4 years in 25 of our workshops. Now, what does S stand for? What is your guess? What do you think?
Saudi Arabia?
No. And those who know it, please don't answer it. Yes. Speaking.
Stand.
All right. The S stands for the smile on your face and in your heart. So the S stands for the smile. And smile not only on your face, but on your heart as well. The smile is the excitement that you have. You know that nervousness, that beating of the heart? Call it excitement, not nervousness. Don't call it anxiety. Rename it in your mind, because that's what the NLP says, Neuro Linguistic Programming. That when you change the label that you give to your state of mind, your whole body reacts to it differently. So the anxiety that you're going through and the nervousness, name it the excitement. And automatically this excitement will bring you to this stage of smile on your heart and on your face. So when you are excited, when you're in a good mood, you will speak good when you come over here. That's the formula of public speaking. So that is the first step, smile. Now what does S stand for? Any guess?
Attention.
Huh? Attitude?
Attention.
Attention, wow. Do you know the formula already? Yes, I think so. All right. So attention. Give your 100% undivided attention to the table topic master who is giving you the topic. Because that's where it all begins. If you can hear the question, the topic effectively, you will be able to speak good on that. Most of the people, they come over here and they see the audience, everyone is staring at them and they're like, why are you staring at me? So you see this happens. Don't think that the audience is there. only focus on the table topic master. That's the second step. 100% undivided attention to the topic that is given to you. Even if you have to close your eyes so that you are able to listen effectively. So that's the second thing, attention. Now, what does the P stands for? Pause. Okay, ji. The third formula, the third step of this formula stands for the pause. Now, here's a mistake that most of us does. That we immediately start talking on the topic. And what happens when you immediately start talking? The nervousness, the anxiety takes over you. You first have to relax. Give a pause. Now, here's the thing. Sir Winston Churchill, he used to have a very sharp mind and a very witty mind. Someone asked him that, how are you able to answer the question so effectively and on the point that the other person has nothing to say? Now, he has given us a formula that he says that whenever someone asks me some question, he used to, you know, smoke a cigar. He used to do it like this. And five to 10 seconds, he take a pause in his cigar. And during that time, he thinks of the answer. So, ab yahan pe cigar rehne se lagane se to hum rahe. So, the pause formula, the Toastmaster, the pause formula, it works. Just stay calm. Look at all the audience. 3, 5, 6 seconds. Then acknowledge the Table Topic Master. Thank you, Table Topic Master, for the topic that you have given me. Dear Toastmasters and distinguished guests, I am very delighted to speak on this subject. Now, here's the thing. When you use a couple of sentences which are already in your mind like this, thank you, thanking the audience, thanking the table topic, during that time, the topic that has been given to you, uske bare mein khyal aa jata hai. You get to know what you have to speak on that topic. Now, let me give you an example. Let's say, for example, someone comes over here and gives me a topic to speak on trees. Okay, the trees. What is the first thought that comes to your mind regarding the trees?
Green.
Oxygen. Now start talking on the oxygen. Start talking on the oxygen because that is the first thought that you have received. Now what happens is when you start talking on the first thought that you have received on the subject, keep on talking, and then you will going to get a second thought. Good for environment, trees are good for environment. And then you, out of nowhere, you will remember the quotation that if every tree gives us free Wi-Fi, we would, you know, build more and more trees. We would take more and more seeds into the ground. But unfortunately, the trees only gives us oxygen. So that's the thing. You will get to remember and recall everything regarding that topic. Now here's another thing most of us are afraid of. Most of us think that the topic that has been given to us, we have no idea about the topic. For example, I'm not good in politics, and someone gives me a topic on politics, what am I going to do? Like with Osama today. So what happens is, the confidence, it does not come from the knowledge that you have. Confidence does not come from the information that you have. Confidence comes from knowing exactly what you know and what you don't know. Because we humans, we cannot know everything. Is it possible to know everything? No. For example, if I am given a topic on politics, how I am going to respond? First of all, I am going to respond it very confidently. And second, I am going to admit that I am not good in politics. That's the thing. Be confident in admitting that you don't know about the topic. And then says, in my case, I start off with the corruption begins from ourselves. And if we give someone a time of 8 o'clock, if we reach at 8:05, we are being corrupt. And the accountability should start from us, not from the politicians. So that's how I respond to the topics of politics. Now there are so many other techniques here, Toastmaster. For example, one other technique. But in all these techniques, SAP formula works. Now the second technique says you have to observe the mindset of the table topic speaker. Now what happens when you observe the mind of table topic speaker, you get to know what type of questions he's giving to all the speakers. And then you will be able to know exactly or maybe near to that question that will be given to you. Or you can also prepare on the theme of the meeting. Just remember some words, just recall some words on the theme of the meeting. And then there's another technique, but if I give it to you, it will become very mainstream and everyone will start using that technique, unfortunately. And then it will no more any technique, but here it is. Dear Toastmaster, for example, any topic is given to you, say like this: imagine if it does not exist. Let's say, for example, if you are given a topic of chair, you just imagine, dear Toastmasters, if chair does not exist, we would all have to sit on the floors. So you know, these are various techniques, but all in all, be confident in, you know, giving this impromptu talks. And the formula of SAP, it works. Now S stands for?
Smile.
A?
Attention.
P?
Pause.
Thank you so much. Over to...